Okay, this is what we're going to be creating. It's not the best thing in the world. It's just a screenshot I grabbed. Arrow doesn't look perfect because I just made it real quick, but this is the general concept. Yeah, so I'll start from the beginning. So here's our screenshot. I'm going to open that up. Sorry, little 16:9 crop. Here's a quick little bonus tip. If you have your layer selected and you come in here and hit convert for smart filters, now anytime you crop, you can crop the heck out of whatever you're working on. Oh no, everything's gone. Well, if it's a smart object, you still have everything there. So you can reset it. So I'm just gonna undo real quick. All right, let's get into the arrow. So we're gonna be using the pen tool. I'm gonna hit the P to activate the pen tool. Up here, depending on your interface, it might look something like this, fill and stroke. I set the stroke to 0, but I'm gonna set the fill to white. And we're gonna do our main, like, two-dimensional part of the arrow. Now, in order to make it look realistic, it's nice to have something to reference for your curves in the image. And here, we've got a nice reference. We've got our pavers here. And we're not gonna obviously put the arrow right on the pavers, but we can use at least this part of the curve to define the shape of our arrow. So let's say I want an arrow. Well, if we can go back to our thing, we want our arrow to go from here to there. So I'm gonna start by, I've got my pen tool activated. I'm gonna drop a point right there, and I'm gonna drop a point about where I want it to end. Now we're just gonna do the shaft, okay? We're gonna keep things as separate and non-destructive as possible. So I'm gonna set my second point here. A quick note, make sure this is on shape. If you have it on path, this isn't gonna work, so shape. So we've got a straight line. Well, how do we make it curved? This is what I love about the pen tool in Photoshop. The way it works is as soon as I place a point here, it automatically sets my Bezier curves. So I'm gonna hold down Command, which is gonna turn this into the Select tool. If you want to use the Direct Select tool, you can do that, but Command is a nice, or Control is a nice shortcut for that. So I'm gonna grab this point, and you'll see I've already got a nice auto Bezier curve, and I'm just gonna kind of move that point around until I get it pretty close. I'm not masking or anything here, so I don't need it to be crazy precise, just precise enough to have a realistic look. So that's our first curve. Now, I want that arrow to go kind of to the left of Heather here. So I'm gonna, and I'm also having it like flat across the top. It's rotated, you know, 90 degrees on the Z axis, I guess, or yeah, whatever. So I'm gonna imagine if there were if the ground were flat right here, like where would it be? So I'm imagining it's about here. And then I'm gonna come over here and do the same thing, and it's gonna be like maybe there, okay? And then we're gonna do the same thing for a curved line right around the same place, place a point, hold down Command or Control, and then I'm gonna drag that out until it looks about right. Now here's what's great about using vectors in the pen tool is we can adjust this as we go. So we don't have to be perfect right now. This is one of the kind of things that's always important when you're creating graphics is to just rough it out and then come back and refine. So once we've set that, let's not forget to complete our shape. So I'm gonna hover over where you'll see a little circle there. I don't know if you can see that, but we're completing our shape. Okay, so now our shape is complete. Boom, so that's our shaft. Now, I'm gonna come into the layers panel and rename that shaft so it's easy to keep track of. Now we're gonna do the head of the arrow, and we're gonna do something similar for our flat line here. We're gonna make sure first off that we're not selecting this, because otherwise we'll make a complex path. So make sure the first path isn't selected. And then I'm gonna do the same thing and make like the straight line across there. So boom. Boom, again, we don't have to be super accurate. I am gonna fix this point though, because I don't love where it's at. And then we're gonna place our tip of the arrow boom. Again, it just has to be pretty close, right? Because again, we can adjust things until it looks right. Okay, so I'm gonna rename that layer head so it's easy to keep track of. Now, we've done the 2D part. I'm gonna select both of those. I'm holding down Shift and selecting both of those layers. Command or Control G, and that's gonna group it. I'm gonna rename that arrow 2D. Okay, so now we've got this. If you want, you could be done here, okay? But we wanna go 3D, right? We want to go boom. So if we do that, now again, make sure nothing's selected. We still have our pen tool, and here it just takes a little bit of basic technique. You're gonna look at all the hard points, boom, 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 and we're gonna imagine a straight line coming down. I mean, you could like drag a ruler out if you wanted to, cool, but we don't really need to do that because we don't need to be that precise. So I'm gonna zoom in, and then I'm gonna place a point here and go straight down. You could even hold down Shift if you want. Again, this is also gonna depend on the orientation of your arrow. Here we're nicely oriented at like, you know, horizontal to the ground. But you could always just imagine your straight line. So same here. I mean, the Shift here doesn't work because I need to come straight down from here. So again, placing this down. Again, another hard point, placing this down. Sorry, one thing I forgot to do is change my fill to black. You don't need to do this, but it just makes it easier to see what you're doing. And also, if you want, you can drag that layer below the other one so that we can kind of see what we're doing. Now, remember, this thing is getting closer to us, so the distance from each of these is going to get a little bigger as we go. But it's vector. It's non-destructive, so we can adjust this as need be. So I'm just going to guess here, drop it there, boom. Again, straight down, drop it there, and then meet this point, boom. And then I can be somewhat rough here because I just need it's going to be underneath. And then, of course, we're going to do the same thing. I placed a point here, and then this is going to let us set our curve. So you can see already we've got a funky looking thing, but it's pretty close, right? So our shape is there, boom. So I need to make some adjustments here. Okay, that's a little bit better. This is, you know, maybe a little fat, I think. So I'm just gonna push everything up a little bit. Cool. So you may have noticed, the eagle-eyed among you may have noticed that I missed this part in here. So again, I did this on purpose because this helps us demonstrate the non-destructive aspect of vectors. So I can place a point here. Now, this is also another reason why I wanted to show you this. If I place a point here, it's gonna already have the Bezier curve, so it's gonna make it hard to do that. So I'm gonna hold down Option, which I believe is Alt on, I almost said piano. Why did I say piano? On Windows, the window beside the piano. And then again here, I'm gonna place another point and then hold down Option and remove the Bezier curves. And that'll allow me to have a straight line here. Boom, boom. Okay, and then zooming back out. Hey, look at that. It's not great, okay? I'm not gonna spend the time to like super refine this, even though I kinda want to. Let's just do a little bit, okay? This is a little, oops, sorry. I'm not in my pen tool. Okay, there we go. So there, that's a little bit better. Okay, and then if you really want to get precise, you can really zoom in and make sure all these points and stuff are great. But we're talking about a thumbnail right now, and most people aren't gonna see that, but it's up to you. It's up to the quality of your moral compass. All right, so now, here's where we get fun with color. I need to rename this. I'm gonna rename this extrude because that's what you do in 3D. Sometimes you take a 2D thing and you extrude it to 3D. We could have used extrude here, but I like it this way because then I can really control the colors. So let's go back to our Aero 2D. This is why we grouped this, because I'm gonna double click on it, choose my gradient overlay. You can see I already have a gradient overlay set up. Here it's linear. I can change my angles to kind of like mess with it. You just kind of like do this to taste. Scale, this will affect it. I don't have a huge color shift here, so let me give me a little more color shift so we can see it a little bit more. And we'll go a little more red on the other side. Cool. And cool. And then again, so your scale will kind of affect where this lives. You can reverse it if you want to make it easy. And then your angles will also kind of affect what that looks like. So do I want it like this? Do I want it like that? I kind of like it like that. Cool. And now we're going to do the same for the extrude. If you want, you can hold down Option or Alt, grab that gradient overlay and drop it right onto your extrude. Whoa, that doesn't look right. Well, a quick way here is to just reverse it. And that looks pretty decent, but I like to get a little fancier and make a 3-point gradient. Oops, a 3-point gradient so that we get that little kind of shift around the corner, around the turn, like that. And then usually I'll kind of darken things a little bit because it's on the side, or I'll even lighten it. Depends on what's going on. The light right now is coming from this direction, so the shadow is going to be over here. So I'm probably going to go a little bit darker over here, you know, like that. Again, to taste, you know, because this is a thumbnail for YouTube, so, you know, it could be whatever colors. It doesn't have to be realistic. This is just a little bounce light, you know? It's a little bounce light. Because, you know, the sun's not over there, but it's gonna bounce. It's gonna bounce off the ground and kind of back into here. And that gives us a little stuff. Now, if you're in Photoshop still, let's do one last thing. We're gonna shift, select these, group them, arrow, 3D. Organization is the key to somethingimation that rhymes with organization. Now I can select this, hit Command T or whatever, and move it around. Now I've got my arrow. You'll see here, okay, you all can already see, like, maybe it's pointed a little bit up. I can rotate it, make it really work. And if I want to get into the vectors, I can do that and adjust stuff. Like this over here is bugging the crap out of me. I don't like how pointy that is, but we'll leave it for now. Now, you'll notice that our mask, or our, I just gave it away, but we've masked this part of the arrow out so that Heather is showing through. So in Photoshop, if you select the wand, the object select tool, I love this tool. You can be like, just real rough. Sound effects required. And then Photoshop is like, sure, bud. And you'll see we're missing a little bit right here. I could zoom in and shift, hold down shift, and then add that. And you'll see it added it. It's pretty close. Good enough, y'all. Good enough. So I have my selection. I could do a couple of things here. I could make a second layer that has just Heather in it, which is actually usually what I do because I like to use that to separate stuff. Actually, let's do that. Let's lose our selection. I'm going to hit Command J, which is going to duplicate our layer, rename it Heather. And then we're going to do the same thing again. And you'll see here, it's like it already knows there's an object here. And I can just click on that if I want. And then I'm going to add shift, hold down shift, and grab the arm. That's not great. Let's do it again. Boom. Okay. It's pretty good. We'll fix this later. So then I'm just going to mask that part. And now I can put her on top of the arrow. And now I have a mask here, selecting the brush tool now. And the brush tool on a mask works like this. If you paint black on the mask of this thing, it hides it. If you paint white, I'm gonna hit X to change to white. It lets it show through. So I can paint that in real quick. Boom, 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 boom. And there we go. That's it. There's a whole bunch of other tips I can share, but I hope this gets you there. So like, subscribe, share, comment, and until next episode, nobody's gonna see this. Oh, I just realized I didn't show you how to do that shadow. So we had the shadow under here. This is super easy, should only take a second. So we've got our arrow 2D. I'm gonna hold down Option and drag that, and that's gonna duplicate it. You could have also just hit Command J or Control J. I'm gonna, it's not in the group. That's fine. We're gonna call it arrow shadow. I like to name everything. Now we're going to turn over, I double clicked over here to open up these effects, turn off gradient overlay, turn on color overlay. You'll see it's black. So Command T to get into my transform. I like to do it this way because it makes it so that I'm not accidentally grabbing anything else. So now I have my black arrow, which is a shadow, which should like really be like way the heck over here. But again, we're not going for reality. We're going for like readability. It's maybe a better way to put it. So there, boom. We want to blur it. Again, I don't like to do anything destructive. So I've got this arrow shadow as a group, filter, convert for smart filters. So now I can change the gradient at will. So Gaussian, Gaussian, Gaussian. Blur 6, and then I'm hitting V, which selects my selection tool. And when that's open, you can usually hit just a number on the keyboard to change opacity. Or if you want to, you can come in here and hit opacity. Really, it shouldn't be blurred because if you look at Heather's shadow, it's very clean. But if I don't blur it, or I just put like maybe a 1 pixel blur, you know, which is a kind of about where her shadow is at. It just kind of, I don't know, maybe you do what you want. I'm going to put a blur on it and then just kind of like scoot it around until it looks about right. Really, the whole thing with the shadow is to make it so that you can place it right, so you can really see where it is. If I turn it off, you can see like where that arrow is, but if I turn it on, like you can really see it. And again, this is gonna depend on your needs and how dark it needs to be or how fuzzy it needs to be. I mean, you could like really fuzzy it out. You know, let's go like 20 and then like up the opacity a little bit. And that just kind of gives it a little bit of a read. So if I like zoom way out, like then you can like really read that arrow a lot better if I'm zoomed out. But personally, I would probably keep it pretty subtle with the blur. Okay, that's that.
Thank you for watching. The end.